Greetings all, it's the Devious Monkey here. Okay, it is a glorious Thursday in my world, and I got back off the road yesterday, and that was like my first week up to Maryland. I did get a chance to meet up with my friend Jennifer, and it was awesome, because we haven't seen each other in like almost 2 years. And so we hung out a little bit just at the hotel, caught up a little bit, and then we went out to dinner, and she introduced me to an Irish pub type setting, and I got bangers and mash, and it was awesome. So we had a good time. It was great to catch up. We might do it again next week because she's still going to be in Maryland, and I have to go back up there to Frederick, where I found that canal in the downtown area. So we might meet up there, weather depending and what's going on, and that'll be peachy. In the meantime, the saga of my new lens purchase. Honestly, I've filmed so much every day, and I've ranted about this so much that I actually don't even know or remember if I even put anything out about it. But needless to say, I decided that I was going to reconfigure my A7C into a street photography setup, since I used to do that all the time way back when I lived in Chicago, and I missed it. The A7 R4, granted, fantastic camera and all that kind of stuff, but I've pretty much been using that for the birding, so it pretty much always has the 200 to 600 lens on it now, and you know, that's how it's set up, and I take it out and I do that. I kind of don't want to take the A7 R4 out for street photography, and since I have been using the second ZV-1 back in its, I guess, run and gun filming setup, that's pretty much what I've been using for filming. And of course the A7C, while it's great for filming, it was a little bit big for daily vlogging. So that's why I've been using the ZV-1, and I've just been lazy and I haven't done anything cinematic, like any of the like documentaries that I said I was gonna do, like probably for over a year now. Basically, I wanted to set up this A7C for street photography, and I wanted it to be compact and light, but good. So I did some research and everything, and pretty much came to the conclusion that I didn't want like the nifty 50. I didn't want to spend $1,000 on the 55 1.8 Sony lens, and I didn't want to go 35. I've decided I really don't need a 35, certainly not now. Besides, they're all pretty big, except for the 1.8. But, okay, bottom line, I decided to go with one of the newer Sony lenses, where they let out those three lenses. They let out a 24 2.8, a 40 2.5, and a 50 2.5. And I opted to go in between the 35 and the 50, and I went with the 40 2.5 G lens. Very small, compact, but it got great reviews. Everybody says it's a really sharp lens, works well with the Sony full frame system, blah, 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 blah. And when it got right down to it, I thought that'd be perfect. Now, the only other thing that I had to change about this camera was the fact that, and I use the term loosely, the lens finder, the viewfinder, didn't really have an eye cup on it. In fact, to me, it looked like, and I actually did this when I got the camera, I looked in the box to see if the eye cup fell off. That's how pathetic the eye cup is. I decided I wanted to have something on there because I didn't want to just constantly be looking at the screen. I actually wanted to get it up to my eye and take a picture. So did a little research on that and ended up finding an eye cup mechanism that slides into the hot shoe and went with that. I also didn't want to carry a big-ass neck strap. I got enough shit, you know, hanging off me and everything, and I didn't really need it anyways. I wanted to go with a wrist strap, so I did a bunch of research on that, and I found Lucky Straps, a place in Australia that custom makes straps, and I ended up ordering one of those, and I got it pretty quick, considering it came all the way from Australia, and I had it custom stamped with Devious on it and all that stuff, but I made a mistake, and they have traditional ends, and then they also had their new like speed ends that allow you to take it on and off the camera really quick. And I don't know what I was thinking. I ended up getting the traditional, which means you have to put it on and it stays on the camera. And I didn't want that. So today, first thing I did today is I went out and I found a quick connect, like buckle, whatever mechanism that I could put on here and have it be a quick release. So without further ado, here's the camera. So this is the Sony A7C. I have the 40 millimeter 2.5, and you can see the eye cup that goes on there. And then you can see it comes across here and it slides right into the hot shoe. And then you actually, I mean, it sticks out kind of far. It's a little more obnoxious than I would like, but when you've got a big schnoz like this, it's perfect for keeping it off of the back of the screen. Even if I were to look with this eye and have my face like right up on the screen, it doesn't touch. And I've got a big greasy schnoz, so that's a plus. Now, here is the strap. This was by Lucky Straps, as you will hopefully, yeah, there's their symbol. You can see the Devious that I had stamped in there. So just a little personalization. And basically, that's the quick release that I put on, and it's teeny. So there you go. Now it comes apart, and I can just, you know, take the strap off when I want and just have the camera like this. In order to give you the maximum amount of information available, I have gone through and I have weighed this all out, apart and together. So the camera, the Sony A7C, and that's, here we go, the camera like this that has the eye cup on it, the plate at the bottom, and this is not the Peak Design standard plate, this is the PGY Tech Mantis Pod one, so it doesn't spin or anything like that. And I ordered a couple more of these and I don't know when they'll be in. You know, standard battery, memory card, and that's it. That's all I weighed. Well, and then the end of this little piece, so from here on, that comes in at 536 grams. So not too bad, it's very light. The lens only weighs 200 grams, and then the strap by itself, when I disconnect it, weighs 49 grams. So yeah, lump all that together, stick it on there, and it comes up to 785 grams. And that's it. It is incredibly light, very compact, and it's a lot of fun to take out. Just slide my hand in there, and there you go. Now if you drop it, you've got a tether, stays out of the way. Just get your thumb under there. You can touch all the controls. You don't have anything hanging off your neck and all that kind of crap with all the other shit that I carry, and it's awesome. Bottom line is, I wanted to go with something different. That's why I went with the 40 millimeter instead of the 50 or the 24. You get in between a 35 and a 50, you get a 40. And it's 2.5, and I haven't had much time to play with it just because I've been busy. I did take a couple of pictures while I was on the road, and I'll show you those right now. This was just a bird that had flown up on the rim of the hotel, and I was like, oh cool. So I snapped a picture of it just to see what it would look like. And then in the hotel, they had this weird thing that had like rocks and LEDs in it that was changing colors and all that shit. So I snapped a pic of that, and I used it on manual focus so that I could have it focus not where it wanted to autofocus, and snapped that pic, and I thought that looked great. The inaugural picture for every one of my cameras or lenses is always my wife. I took a picture of her, but she was sitting down on her little spot on the couch and she'd kick my ass if I posted it. So you're not going to get to see that. Suffice it to say, it looked great. She's a hottie. The lens has autofocus, manual focus switch. It does have a programmable button there that I probably won't do anything with. And it has an aperture ring, and you can de-click that and make it nice and smooth. I don't really see using it for filming. I've got other lenses for that shit, but I could, and then I could put it on de-clicked and have smooth transition of aperture without making any noise. Bottom line though, this is perfect. This is perfect to go out and do street photography, or any kind of photography for that matter. This lens is, you know, I mean, it's not a 70 to 200. It's not a 16. It's not 1.8 or 1.4. It's a nice 2.5. You know, most people will do a lot with a 2.8. This gives just a smidge more open than that at 2.5. So you can really get some isolation. You can get some great bokeh. It looks great. I don't need to kick a dead horse. This combination is exactly what I envisioned when I decided I wanted to do street photography again and what I wanted it to be. Great lens. Everything looks sharp. It's a good looking setup if you're into that sort of thing. And that's another reason why I got this strap. It is all leather, handmade. and custom. They make it for you, you know, like after you order it, and you know, you can pick all, what kind of end you want. You can get the customization like I did with getting it stamped. You can send them your logo. You can choose a different color for the stamp if you don't want it. I just wanted it stamped with Devious on there just because that's, I'm Devious. And that's that. So I got my street photography set up all good to go. Unfortunately, it's been like 2,000 degrees out with 10,000 humidity. And I was gonna go out this afternoon after I had lunch with my wife. And I was like, man, it looks like it's gonna kind of rain. And she's like, yeah, I saw that. So I looked it up and it said it was supposed to rain, start thunderstorming around 5 or 6. And whilst I was sitting here looking something up on the internets, it kept getting darker and darker. And before I realized, I was like, Jesus, it's like it's nighttime outside. And then the thunder and lightning started and it started to rain. So not going out today to do any kind of photography whatsoever. That is it. That's all I've got. If you have any questions or comments or suggestions or whatever, want to say hello, say hello. I love that. Put it in the comment section down below. I am going to link the iCup thingamajigger and the strap. As far as the camera and the lens go, you know where to buy that kind of crap. As always, thanks for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, kids, forward and up.